Hey guys, welcome back. I've got a great update for you. So yesterday, as this video is coming out on Friday, so Thursday afternoon-ish, Antelope have finally dropped the new firmware update for the Orion. Now, what this firmware update does is allow you to put the unit into 64 channel mode instead of 128, and this allows you to use the 1024 buffer size. Obviously, this affects me in Pro Tools, but also any other DAW, this will be applicable. So I'm going to show you how to run the firmware update and also what that looks like in Pro Tools and how this all works after the update's been completed. Now, unfortunately, I can't run the firmware update on camera because I've already done it. The reason for that is, obviously, I have to test it before I go on video and say, it's great! So I've run it, I've tested it, I've used it for a few hours, I've gone in a few sessions, I've used outboard, yada yada yada, working absolutely fine, no problems at all. But I'll show you where to go in the menu should you wish to do this update, because you have two options. We'll jump into Pro Tools shortly and I'll show you what the I/O menu now looks like and all that kind of thing. But the key takeaway is, finally, Antelope have answered the call. So for those guys that need a 1024 buffer size, you now have that available at the expense of less I/O available from the unit. Now, like I'd said in the previous video, and if you haven't seen it, I'll put a card up here somewhere, but that isn't the fault of Antelope, it's to do with the limitation of Thunderbolt. So if you're going to have 128 inputs on Thunderbolt, you don't have the luxury of having a 1024 buffer size. You have to go with 512 being your maximum option. Obviously, Antelope have recognised the fact that not everybody needs 128 I/O, and some people are perfectly happy using 32 and using it all analog, or 64 in my case, because I'm joining the two Antelopes together, or if you wanted to use, you know, an additional MADI converter or something like that, 64 would be a great option. So that's exactly what they've done. So to recap, 64 I/O available, 1024 buffer size now available, and you can actually switch between these firmwares at will. So if you end up in a situation where you need 128, but you're not bothered about having 1024, you can actually flash the firmware to the 1024 version as well. So that's a cool option. Anyway, let's jump onto the Antelope software. Let me show you all about it. Alrighty, so here is the Antelope software. When you open it up, you'll see your main Antelope device available. And this gear cog icon will have a tiny little red dot above it, which will show you that there's an update available. Now, if you click into this cog, you'll see I am the 64.1.2 current firmware, which is 64 channel Thunderbolt. If you click down here, you'll have an option for 128 channel Thunderbolt. As you can see, the previous firmwares were all 128. Today, we got these two, which is a 64 and the 1.1.22. So you can choose between either of those options. I'm on 64 channel. What this means is, when you open up the Antelope launcher, you will see the following. Now, you only have 64 channels available. You can still see your other options, but they won't work. You're limited to 64. I've put mine down in the standard way last time that we had them, which is line in to door out to line in, yada yada, and then we're going out to MADI, and we're coming in from the MADI back to the line in. So essentially exactly the same way as the other video. I've got 32 I/O on the first Antelope and 32 I/O on the second being fed over MADI. How does this look in Pro Tools? Well, let's have a little look. Let's launch this sucker and see how we go. All right, so we're here in Pro Tools and let's have a look at the I/O settings first of all. If you can see inputs, you now only have 64 available. Originally, it was showing 128. Same with outputs. Only 64 in there and originally 128. Inserts haven't changed. They're still exactly where they were before, but they now stop at 64. Everything you would expect. But The important thing is that if we go into the playback engine, voila, we now have the 1024 option, whereas before we were limited at 512. And there we have it, folks. That is how you run the new Antelope software, and that is what gets you to the 1024 buffer size. So all the people in the previous video's comments complaining it was taking too long, sorry about that, but it's here now and it all works fine. So go forth, upgrade your firmware, and if you run into any problems or anything like that, you want to discuss it, do so in the comments below. Short and sweet video. Hope this helps some of you out there. See you next week.